in 1991 in Parvani Committee. They gave the recommendation as to they need to have a national stock exchange. And it was traded in equities, shares, bonds and other government securities. It has ranked the third position since the last 4 years. Now presently there are 24 stock exchanges in India. So if you have to go through which are the, though the heading says the other 21, these are the 23 nominated stock exchanges what we can find in India. Can we move on to the next slide? Yeah. Now, just before going to SEBI as to it is a regulatory body. Now, do you agree with me that every sector has a regulatory body? Yes. Now, which are the sectors you find? I say stock exchange is one. The other parallel to it is the banking industry. The other parallel to on the right hand side is the insurance industry. Now, do you know that there are the regulatory bodies to these also?
Yes.
Now, who regulates the banking sector?
RBI.
Who regulates the insurance sector? Who regulates the insurance sector? Now, it is the Insurance Regulatory Development Authority, IRDA, regulates the insurance sector. Now, why these regulatory bodies? Why do we need to have a regulatory body? Bank has been regulated by a body called RBI. IRDA regulates insurance. Now, stock markets and other things have been regulated by SEBI. Now, why do we need these regulatory bodies? It is not privatized. Pardon? Any illegal activities. Okay. Now when we say regulation, it is basically to have a surveillance. Okay. First and foremost is to have some rules and regulations framed as to everybody go by those rules and regulations. The second concept is to monitor and have a vigilant in terms of who is getting deviated, and that is how the SEBI is with the regulation of stock markets. Am I boring you? Yes ma'am? No? Okay. Now, I will not take you through the slide what all the contents is, just to take you through the objectives of the SEBI. Now, to protect the interest of investors in securities and to promote development and to regulate the security market for matters concerned therewith. Now, why do it has to regulate? Just in to see and ensure that your and my money, if we have saved it. Now, when we save the money, is it really hard for us to save? Correct? To keep aside 1,000 rupees a month or 5,000 rupees is really difficult for us, because the world is very tempting. If I want to go for a movie, I can arounce spend 1,000 rupees. Correct? If I go on for a shopping, having 1,000 rupees in my pocket, I end up coming back home spending 3,000 rupees. You agree with me? So this is the kind of situation we have in the world, and it is very difficult for us to save. And when we are saving and putting the money into either the bank, which gives a minimum of 8%, 9% interest, or could be we are investing it in securities or we are investing in insurance. So these are all hard-earned money of the investors, and the regulatory body makes it a point that every investor's money is being taken care, safeguarded, and ultimately the government is also benefited out of it. To know when we talk about the security markets. Sensex and Nifty. Correct? What is Sensex? Sensex? Nifty? Pardon?
Bombay Stock Exchange, the index is known as Sensex and for the National Stock Exchange.
Okay. Agreeable. It is the 30 largest and most actively traded stocks. talk about census. Now everybody who wants to invite the public money gets themselves registered, listed, and then invite the public to invest with them. Correct? Now, if I move on to the top 30 in the listed companies, then the representative of various sectors, I come into the top 30 category. Now, these companies account for around 1/5 of the market capitalization in the BSE. The base value, when the way back it was started in 1971, the base value was 100. Okay? And the base year of Sensex BSE, we call it as 78-79. Now, which are the different sectors which come into the Sensex? Now, here is a brief description about now capital goods, transportation, IT sector, FMCG, oil and gas, finance, metal, power, healthcare, telecom, all of them having their share in the Sensex. Now, going on to the Nifty, it is the 50 top, or what we call as Nifty 50, is the flagship index of the National Stock Exchange. The index tracks the behavior of the portfolio blue chip companies, the largest and most liquid Indian securities. Now, if we talk about around 1600 companies listed on the NSE, captures about 65% of its flat adjusted market capitalization and the true reflection of the Indian stock market. Now, here it goes. The media and telecommunication has its share, consumer goods, construction, telecom, industrial manufacturing, cement, metal, automobile, financial services, pharma, IT, and what did I mean? Hearing? Now, how do we go about it? Anything to be asked? Shall we move on? Now, I have divided this 2 hours of my session into 2-3 parts. Now, till now, I just gave you a brief about how do we zoom into the stock market. Now on, I take you through the terminologies, how to go about it. Now, could be like, what do you need to have a share in the market? Okay, how is it happening? What is the trading days? How you can trade actually, online, offline? Can I move forward?
Yes,
sure?
Yes.
Okay. Now, you all know that to have to purchase shares in the equity market, we need to have something called as demand. Yes, you are all aware about it?
Yes.
Then, what's the market timings? Okay, it's on the slide. You can at least go through that. 9:30 every day morning it starts and it goes up to 3:30 in the noon. So, the opening time when I talk about it is at the 9:30 morning, you have an opening time or the points through which you can start your trading, or you can look into as to which company is going on an upper trend or the lower trend. Then, now trading requirements, if you have to trade, you need to have a PAN card, then you need to have a DMAT account, then subscribe to a trading account with one of the major online broking houses. Now, major challenge starts in the learn trading. You can read different books and journals and the other blogs which can help you out in how to trade, how to buy the shares. And the fourth step is apply your knowledge and start trading. If you are good enough, if you are very, like people told me that I am very good in analysis, I can study and I can understand what is happening in the market, then you can make your trading on your own. Suppose if you want to gain knowledge, you can use a different other aspects like blogs, books and other online trainings, and you can go for it. Now there are two types of trading. One is the offline trading, through which you can ask your brokers to trade for you and you can go in for a online trading process. Now, why stock prices rise or fall? Why stock prices rise or fall? Okay, I have a video for you.
Sure, we all sleep for 7-8 hours.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am, only then we can spend the next 16 hours. Yes? So we sleep for 8 hours. So first 8 hours is gone. Productive time. Okay? We get energy and we try to accumulate all kind of positive energy. We get ready for the next day. The next 8 hours, what do we do? College? Okay. Now what's your college timings? 8:30 to 3:30 takes you how many hours?
6
hours. Where are the 2 more hours? Commuting. Okay, so the second 8 hours is gone. Do you attend all the classes?
Yes.
But what I heard is most of you are not filling your form because you have not got 75% attendance. Pardon? So, if you are not in the class 75% also, then where are you? Lot of commitment, ma'am. We will have so many things outside to do. Lot of movies come every week. So we need to make them richer and richer. So we need to ensure that even the Golmaal back is not so good when compared to superstar of Amir Khan's
Secret Superstar.
We want to make Ajay Devgan richer and get into that 100 crore, not this Amir Khan. Am I right? So that is why the 75% has not reached. Okay, fair enough. You come to college, 8:30 to 3:30, 6 hours has gone there, 2 hours for your commute. What about the next 8 hours? You slept already.
Social media.
Social media. 8 long hours. Half an hour Instagram, half an hour Facebook, half an hour WhatsApp. I don't agree with you. If you sit with Facebook and WhatsApp, you will wind up in half an hour.
Lunch, breakfast, dinner.
10 minutes. Half an hour is gone. Pardon? You need to prepare your food?
Yes.
Okay. So how long you might take to prepare your food? 1 hour. Okay. So Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, 1.5 hours. Then 1 hour for cooking, 2.5 hours. Then eat. 10 minutes, half an hour. So 3 hours.
Again, a small nap.
Okay, nap means, you know the definition of a nap? It should not go beyond 20 minutes. That is a nap. Okay, if you are sleeping more than 20 minutes, that is a sleep. Okay, so again, 3.5, 4 hours. Where are the next 3 hours going? Homework. Okay. There comes the last thing. In your 24 hours, thinking about your studies, homework, assignments and those things in the last 3 hours. This is how you spend. Okay. In the corporate world, this is how it has been taught. Suppose if you work for 8 hours, if you work religiously and spend quality time of 8 hours every day, then you can spend the next second 8 hours with your family and your children. Okay? Now, 8 hours has not been uniform these days. It's all extended work hours plus commute. So, it will take you to sometimes 10 and sometimes 12 also. So, 12 hours. So, the next time is with your family and your children. Then comes, if you happen to do the first 8 to 10 hours properly, the next 8 hours utilize properly. Otherwise, you know how you behave with your loved ones when you are irritated, when you are not being happy, when you are not being treated well in the office or college. And only then you can sleep 8 hours peacefully. Or else, again the bad routine will start. Neither you can sleep, then nor you can work, then again nor you can spend your time with the family. So these 8 into 3 has to happen always. Okay, shall we get back to stock? So, why stock price rises? Now, when a company makes a news about it, it rises. Correct? When the company creates an hype about it, genuinely or not, it makes the price of the share rises. News about the country, then exchange rate result, demand and supply. That's what you just saw in the video, how the prices raise and how it has been coming down. It could be genuine or it could be some kind of hype created by the market traders there. Now, what are the benefits of investing in shares? The possibility of high returns. Now, why am I not going and investing my money, all my money in the bank? Why am I not going and investing in the post office? Why am I not buying NSE bonds? Why do I have to go and invest my money into shares only?
The returns are high.
In the technical term, there is something called as appetite. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of appetite? What is the meaning of appetite?
Capacity.
The mere meaning of appetite is capacity. Now, if I have to relate the term to the technical word with the finance, it talks about the risk appetite. Now, the higher the risk appetite I have, the better options I choose to invest. Now, if I am a person with an age category of 50 to 60, say our parents' age, that generation, now do they like to invest their money into say stocks and commodity market or sometimes real estate, going investing money in the site or buying a plot? They will not. Why? They have crossed that age and they want their money to be safe, because they want to see to that in their old days they want something to be to give them the security that yes, I am safe. Correct? Now, when the risk appetite is more, I am investing in shares, else I am going and putting my money in the bank. So, what are the benefits of investing in shares? It gives the returns high. Now, if I have the appetite of owning the risk and taking more money out of my investment, I can invest in shares. Now, unbeatable tax benefit, easy liquidity, income from dividends. So we all know that when we are investing in shares, we are the part of the company and we are eligible for something called as dividends. Correct? Now, if I have to take you through the segmentation of the market again, the markets are again segmented into primary market and secondary market. The new securities issued in the secondary market. Now, how are the offerings given to the public? In the form of IPOs, right issue and preferential issues. Now, types of orders. Now, instruments from investors to brokers, market order. Now, you can buy at the lower price and sell it at the higher price. Market order given priority in trading, no guarantee of execution price. Price could raise or fall from time order is placed to the time it is executed. Now, if I have to talk to you about the limit order, buying and selling order when investor specifies time range, that is buy at 50 rupees or less or sell at 52 rupees or more. So, whenever I am buying, I always see that the price is less, and whenever I want to sell and dispose it, I make sure that I make money out of it. Now, have you heard of this concept called circuit breaker? No? Heard?
Start fighting with each other, not only professional. Before the time out, maybe. That's what the stock exchanges also do. When trading gets very volatile and emotions are running high in the stock market, the stock exchanges declare a time out, which is called the circuit breaker. exchange hearts or carrying launchers. So social workers are usually fixed by the exchanges in advance, and the exchange tells you at which levels of the market the training will be haunted. In Indian market, we have three levels of market-wide circuit breakers. These are at 10%, 15% and 20%. So, based on the daily close of the index, the 10%, 15% and 20% levels are calculated at the beginning of each day. If the market falls or rises by that amount, immediately the circuit breaker kicks in and all trading across the exchanges is halted. To give an example, let me show you how circuit breakers were calculated on a recent session. The previous day Nifty closed at 8776. So, the 10% unit is 877.6. If the Nifty rises by 877.6 or falls by this amount, immediately the circuit breaker for the day will kick in and all trading will be halted. Similarly, there are units at 15 and 20% also. Both Sensex and Nifty declare circuit breakers every day, and when the circuit breaker in one of the exchanges is hit, the other also will stop trading. Basically, trading will resume after a specific halt. Traders are given say half an hour to 1 hour to return overnight and then resume trading. All the orders which are already in the system before the circuit breaker will get invalidated. Once the trading resumes again, you will have to punch in your orders again. Actually, stock market is a place where emotions run very high. Greed and fear, panic, all these have a lot of influence on how stock trading is done. Sometimes when the market is beginning to fall rapidly, everybody wants to jump in and put in sell orders. So the market crashes very fast. Similarly, if a market is rising very quickly, everybody in the market jump onto the bandwagon and buy stocks. But investors get spooked when the markets move too much within a day. So this is why stock exchanges have a circuit breaker mechanism, so that traders will have time to pause, think over the development before reacting in haste. There is also a concept called circuit filter, which is applied to individual stocks. So when a single stock moves by 5%, 10%, 15% in a single day, trading will can be halted. One of the much talked-about trading bonds in India occurred when the UP ran a landslide victory in the Lok Sabha elections in May 2009. Reacting to the win, the Sensex opened 10% higher and the Nifty 14% higher on May 18, 2009. That triggered a trading halt. And circuit breakers are not always triggered by running emotions of traders. Error can sometimes trigger them too. MSC circuit breaker was triggered in October 2012 when a broker for LG Global Services punched in erroneous orders into the system and caused the Nifty to fall by 920 points shortly after the market opened. An interesting aside, Indian markets have had a circuit filter mechanism for stocks for many years now, but this was not so in the US. It was only after the flash crash episode in 2010 that the US regulators decided to have a circuit filter mechanism in place for individual stocks.
Multitask. Correct? We don't do one thing at a time. Do we do? We keep doing two, three things at the same time. Now, my professor has, I had an argument with my professor saying that no, we are all multitaskers. We have to do. Now, I am a working lady. I'm married, having two children, I need to look after my family, I need to make sure that my children goes to school and everything. So I have had an argument with them. No sir, we are all multitaskers. What do you say? Very loyally you are all agreeing. Okay. Now, I have a small exercise to prove that yes, we are all not efficient when we do 2-3 things at a time. Can we execute that exercise? Do we have a pen and a paper with you all? No. Why? Okay, you have come. How many of you have a pen, paper? Okay. Can you just come this way with your pen and a paper? I want that boy to be one of the volunteers.